Hudson Cooper 360, weeknights at 8 and 10 on CNN.
It was December 1989. All little Christopher Milky wanted to do was see Santa Claus. But that's not what happened. He wasn't taken to the mall to sit on Santa's lap. He was taken to the desert and shot execution style. He was just 4. Within hours, investigators identified 2 suspects, James Stiers and Roger Scott. During their interrogation, Scott cracked, then led investigators to the boy's body. But why did they do it? The story began to unfold when Phoenix Police Detective Armando Saldate said Scott told him the boy's mother had also been involved. So Saldate quickly zeroed in on Deborah Milky.
He, in his mind, based upon the little bit of information that he had, was just convinced that this woman did it.
Saldate arrested Milky, a 25-year-old insurance company clerk, and within 20 minutes he announced she'd confessed to arranging for the men to kill her son. The alleged motive? A $5,000 insurance payout. Deborah Milky was charged with first-degree murder. The arrest and charges based solely on Detective Saldate's statements. At Milky's murder trial, Saldate was the state's star witness.
She decided that it'd be best for Christopher Milky to die.
Milky shot back.
And I looked at Saldate and I said, if I didn't want my son, then I could give him, I would have given him to my family, my sister, or someone else in my family.
Still, the jury believed the detective. In 1990, Milky was convicted and sentenced to die.
But that was just the beginning of this strange case. For more than 2 decades, her story has captivated the state of Arizona, especially those here in Phoenix, who have been asking, would Milky really have had her own son killed for $5,000? And if so, why did the 2 men she supposedly hired to do the job refuse to testify against her? Milky has always maintained her innocence and never gave up on her appeals.
Milky insisted she never confessed. Private investigator Paul Hubel believes her. He was working for a local TV station when Christopher Milky was killed and interviewed Deborah a couple of hours after Detective Saldate did.
I said, did you tell the police you had anything to do with the death of your son? She glared at me, her eyes got really big, and she says, that's crazy, who told you that? I had nothing to do with the death of my son.
This is probably my favorite.
But her ex-husband, Christopher's father, disagrees. He always has.
Do you believe your ex-wife killed your son?
Oh, I know she did. I don't believe it. I know she did.
And so that's where things stood until March of this year, as Deborah Milky sat on death row, where they stood until a stunning turn of events. A panel of judges from the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals decided Deborah Milky should get a new trial. In a scathing opinion, federal judge Alex Kozinski tossed out her conviction, suggesting her confession had been illegally obtained, adding, it probably never occurred.
Court documents show Saldate didn't record the alleged confession or his interrogation of Deborah Milky. There were no other officers present in that interrogation room. Nobody was watching through a two-way mirror, and there were no cameras or microphones to record it. And there's more. Saldate never asked Deborah Milky to put her confession in writing, and he even skipped the most basic step of having her sign a Miranda waiver.
The federal appeals court judges didn't say Milky is innocent, but other than her so-called confession, there is no physical evidence linking her to the crime. Judge Kozinski also found prosecutors failed to disclose what they knew about Detective Saldate's history of misconduct, disciplinary action, and lying. The judge cited 8 cases where confessions, indictments, or convictions were tossed out or set aside because Saldate had either lied under oath or violated constitutional rights. In one case, Saldate let a motorist with a faulty taillight go in exchange for sex, then lied to his superiors about it. The judge determined this would likely have cast doubt on Detective Saldate's credibility and may have influenced the verdict.
It's still a fact that she was convicted of the murder of her 4-year-old son.
On Friday, September 6th, 23 years after she was sent to death row, Deborah Milky walked out of prison, a free woman, for now. She was finally able to hug her mother for the first time in more than 20 years. Now 49, Milky is preparing for yet another trial. But this time around, things may be different. A judge will soon decide if her alleged confession is even admissible in court. And Detective Soldate, he may ask for immunity and not testify.
They don't have Soldate to testify, and if they don't have a confession, this case probably has to be dismissed.
Which means Deborah Milky may get used to life on the outside. Randy Kaye, CNN, Phoenix.